Less than 2 minutes to go now before the first heat for the men's pair. We've got a five-boat lineup competing for three places to get through to the AB semi-final. Those that don't progress from this race through to the AB semi-final will have a second opportunity by racing through the repechage. In this five-boat lineup, we have in lane one, South Africa, Cameron Tabara and Callan Barrell. Lane two from Romania, we have the returning world champion of last year, Florin Arteni Fintinariu, now accompanied by Alexandru Gerasim. Lane three for Germany, Kasper Vernakis and Tom Tevez. Lane four for Greece, Ioannis Petalotidis and Yorios Makrigiannis. And then completing the field for the United States of America in lane five, David Eddington and Adam Campaign.
レーススタートまで1分を切りました。本大会2つ目のレースは男子ペア予選です。1組目の紹介をします。1レーン南アフリカ共和国、2レーンルーマニア、3レーンドイツ、4レーンギリシャ、5レーンアメリカです。
Less than 30 seconds to go now before we start with this first heat for the men's pair, the first of three heats to grace us in these opening races for the 2019 World Rowing Junior Championships Tokyo, the first time that Tokyo has hosted an international rowing event in nearly 55 years. So exciting stuff for these young athletes to be competing here today. This first race, just moments from getting started, they'll be up there 2,000 meters away, getting themselves ready. Hot competition here, first three boats to progress. Nobody will be eliminated from this opening race, of course, as we have what's called a second chance opportunity, a repechage for them to go to if they don't progress immediately through from this first heat. My name is Peter O'Hanlon, and joining me up here in the tower is my Japanese co-commentator, Naho Usami. We'll have our commentary team following all of the racing throughout this week, bringing you the latest of the action from right alongside the race in the commentary car. In the car one following this race, we'll have Robert Trahan-Jones and Kenichi Obinata. And following the following race in the second car, we'll have Camilla Hadland and Hiroshi Sugito. So we all look forward to bringing you all of the color and spectacle of this week's racing, which is due to have started just a few moments ago, but as soon as it does, we'll get back straight into that action with this five-boat lineup for the first heat of the men's pair.
The sweet of your skin. Take off your clothes, blow out the fire. Don't be so shy. You're right, you're right. Take off my clothes. Oh, bless me, Father.
So they're now called forward to attention up there at the start. So fingers crossed, any moment now we'll have this first race, the first heat for the men's pair underway. Romania were slightly late at the start, so they've been given a yellow card, and that's caused our delay here. But we now have this start, and it's a rapid one for Romania. They were late at the start. They're not going to be late getting underway here. 52 strokes a minute. Florin Arteni Fintinariu and Alexandru Gerasim getting themselves started. But it's Germany getting on to this early lead here, where we've got Tom Tevez and Kasper Vinekas trying to push out for an early lead. Now we've got Robert Trahan-Jones and Kenichi Obinata following this race right alongside. Good morning, guys. Welcome to the Sea Forest Waterway here in Tokyo. Beautiful view out there on the lake. But tell us, how's this race getting started, Robert?
Thanks, Peter. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, here at the Sea Forest Waterway and listening in worldwide on worldrowing.com. Glorious weather here on the opening morning of racing, greeting the first heat of the junior men's pairs, where, as you've heard Peter just described, Germany has taken the early lead, half a length up on Romania, who in turn have half a length on the USA. Those are the three crews currently in the qualifying positions, followed by South Africa and Greece.
皆さんおはようございます。コメンテーターを務めさせていただきます、小日向と言います。第1回目の記念すべき、国際大会のコメンテーターをさせていただくことに非常に光栄に思っております。第1次レーススタートしました。3クルーが、 セミファイナル A 日に進出します。ドイツと南アフリカが非常にいいスタートを切って今並んで並走しております。それに続いて、アメリカが一定進ぐらい遅れて3位を、維持しております。
Well, we're 500 meters in and it's all change at the head of the field because the Romanians have come powering through in the last 100 meters or so. The Romanians with Arteni Fintinario in the bow seat. He's a world champion in this boat class with his former partner. He went on to get a silver medal at the Youth Olympics earlier this year, and he and his partner Gerasim in the stroke seat have just come moving through and have taken half a length on the fast starting Germans. Back in third place, Eddington and Campaign for the USA. They're coming under a bit of pressure because the pack closing right up, but Greece and South Africa still level for fourth.
第2クォーターに入りました。南アフリカがドイツをやや引き離して一定進捗ほどのリードを奪っています。3位には、アメリカが、追随しておりますが若干水が空いてきているように見受けられます。ジュニアの選手はスカル種目から始める選手が多いので、まあ、このスイープ種目というのは非常に、経験値が浅いと思いますがその周りには非常に力強く上手に漕げていると思います。
Well, there's no stopping the Romanians. They're powering through at 39 strokes a minute. That's an incredible pace because we're through the halfway mark now. They've got a clear lead over the rest of the field, but they're absolutely no let up. They are rowing their own race here in the first heat of the junior men's pairs. They've got about a length and a half clear ahead of Germany. I've got Wernickes and Tevez at 36 strokes a minute at the moment, and they in turn have clear water on the Americans Eddington and Campaign, who are holding off the charge from the two tail enders. The Americans, I've got to say, seem content to sit there in third position. They're in a qualifying slot for the semi-final. They can just glance back and match any move that is made by the South Africans or the Greeks. All four of those athletes in fourth position making their debut here on the Sea Forest Waterway. Moving down towards 12:50, Romania still lead Germany.
250m に差し掛かりました。ルーマニアがさらに水を開けて、ドイツを引き離そうとしています。さらに3位争いがちょっと熾烈になってきました。アメリカをギリシャが、追従して差が少し縮まってきたように思います。3位までに、耐えれば進出準決勝に進出しますので、ここでは負けられない戦いが行われています。
Well, if the Americans thought they were going to have an easy ride in third position, it's Greece now trying to prove their undoing. Makis in the stroke seat of the Greek boat has raised the rate to 38. His partner Petalotidis in the bow seat has responded, and they are closing fast on the Americans, who still seem content to tap it along at 34 strokes a minute. There's about three quarters of a length between those two. We're just over 500 meters out from the finish in this first heat of the men's pairs. The Romanians have just dominated this from the moment they overhauled the Germans. There must be two lengths between those two leading slots. The Germans, though, not dropping the pace, but they have some two lengths of clear water ahead of the USA, and still the Greeks charge on.
はい、ここからも最後のスプリント勝負になってきました。ルーマニアはちょっと水を開けてだいぶ余裕を持って漕いでいるように見えます。ドイツもちょっとレートを上げて最後のラストスパートに入ったようです。アメリカがどうにか逃げ切って3位に入りそうな感じです。
Almost reaching 17:50, 2:50 out from the finish, and Romania are just beginning to ease up a little. They don't want to expend too much energy in this heat and humidity moving through into the semi-final, as they surely must, where they're going to be joined by Germany in second place. But here comes another charge from Greece. This is looking dangerous for the USA. 200 meters to go, third position all to play for, Pete.
Greece really winding it up here, 41 strokes a minute. Yorios Makriganis in the stroke seat, pushing for it to try and get back into that third place, but I think they might run out of water because the USA looks so strong. 38 strokes a minute. Adam Campaign really winding it up for a fast sprint finish.
先頭を引くのはルーマニア、一定差以上を開けています。続いてドイツ、そして3着争い繰り広げているのがアメリカとギリシャ。アメリカがそのまま3位でしょうか。
So Romania across the line for the win, a length and a half ahead of Germany, who have a length and a half of Clearwater ahead of the USA. So those three boats progress through to the AB semi-final, despite a great sprint from Greece. We'll see them contest the repechage, crossing the line here in fourth place, ahead of fifth place on the far side, South Africa.
予選1組目、1着はルーマニア、2着がドイツ、3着がアメリカでした。ここまでがセミファイナルに進みます。そして4着ギリシャ、5着が南アフリカ共和国、こちらが敗者復活戦に挑みます。
The second heat for the men's pair is well underway. We've got another five-boat lineup here. Kasper Pedersen and Tobias Borg-Christensen for Denmark in lane one. Ignacio Medina and Gonzalo Morante for Peru in lane two. They were given a yellow card for being late at the start. Zhang Xuli and Hong Chong Yuan for China in lane three. Hugo Reyes Antillon and Iram Lopez Lucatero for Mexico in four. And then completing the field for France in lane five, Victor Toston Lam and Gregoire Charles.
男子ペア予選2組目は1レーンデンマーク、2レーンペルー、3レーン中国、4レーンメキシコ、5レーンフランスです。
This race now passing the 1000 meters where we've got Camilla Hadland and Hiroshi Sugito following the race. It looks like a good start here for France though, out in front, currently leading by quite a significant margin. So let's hand you over to Camilla and Hiroshi. Camilla, welcome to the Sea Forest Waterway here in Tokyo. Tell us about how this second heat for the men's pair gets underway.
Well, thank you very much, Pete. And yes, it's glorious out here on the water in Tokyo. And it is the first race here for the French pair that's going very well for them. This combination of Charles and Toston Lam out here in front, striking 35 strokes a minute. But it's been all change in the middle of the course. It's been quite difficult to establish second and third. And the early second place went to Denmark. But now Mexico, just with a very patient race, just coming and challenging now for that second place position. These three crews at the front of the field currently looking back on China in fourth with quite the margin.
第2レースすでに中盤に差し掛かっております。第2中継車を担当いたします杉藤と申します。よろしくお願いいたします。5レーンフランス、大きくリードを奪っております。その後、2つのクルーが2位争い、しかしこのレースでは3クルーが準決勝に進出いたしますので、ややセーフティーリードを奪っているという状況でありましょうか。現在1レーン側から、横風が吹く難しいコンディションですが、各クルー力強いストロークで、レースを、展開しております。
Well, it's a real sizable lead here that the French combination have established over the rest of the field. Coach Julien Vallard will be looking at his pair here, thinking that they've got a strong combination, looking to head through to the AB semi-finals. As they go through 500 metres to go, it now must be a number of lengths between themselves and Denmark, who have now pushed back out to three quarters of a length over Mexico, who came alongside to challenge for second position. But they've dropped back a little bit now, but still sit in a qualifying.Fine position for the AB semi-final with three going through.
コンディションがやや難しくなってまいりましたが、第一のフランス非常に力強いストロークで大差をつけて、ゴールに向かっております。今第三クォーター一番苦しいところですが、メキシコ第3位のメキシコ第2位のデンマークと、約一定身でついております。このレースの前、事前合宿、広島、福山での、練習の成果をここで存分に見せたいところです。
So a big push there. I think that the Danish pair have seen that 250 meters is fast approaching and they want to shake off the pressure that Mexico have been putting on them for that second place. They've upped the rating now. They're up at 36 strokes a minute, but the French just too far in the distance to even think about catching. It's going to be a big victory here for the French pair with no disasters in this final 100 meters. And they're now coming close to Peter in the tower.
Yeah, France looking so good out in front. They've led all the way down the course, but pressure is on in third place here, where we see the Mexicans go up to 39, 40 strokes a minute to try and make sure they hold on to a third place finish in this second heat for the men's pair.
スタートから先頭を引っ張り続けたフランスが1着でゴールをしようとしています。2着続くのはデンマークです。
France coming in to cross the line. Grégoire Charles and Victor Tosten Lam take the win here in this second heat, confirming their place through to that AB semi-final. Coming in for second place over on the far side, Pedersen and Christensen for Denmark with a comfortable margin of just over a length ahead of third place Mexico's Reyes Antillon and Lopez Lucatero. So those three boats go through to the AB semi. Coming in for fourth place then we have Zhang and Hong for China. They've eased right up to the line there, taking fourth place. 2 to 3 lengths of Clearwater ahead of Peru's Medina and Morante. We'll see them again in the repechage.
予選2組目、1着でゴールしたのは5レーンのフランス、2着が1レーンデンマーク、3着が4レーンのメキシコ。ここまでの3カ国が準決勝 AB に進みます。4着が中国、そして5着がペルー。こちらは敗者復活戦に挑みます。
Third heat already well underway, just passing through 1200 meters, where we've got Croatia in lane 1, Great Britain in 2, Italy in lane 3, Belgium in 4, and Switzerland in lane 5.
男子ペア予選3組目、1レーンクロアチア、2レーンイギリス、3レーンイタリア、4レーンベルギー、5レーンスイスで行われています。
This race already passing through 1300 meters, so we'll jump straight into the action with Robert.
Yes, Pete, and in this third heat, it's the Italians who've dominated this race virtually from the outset, just over a length ahead of Croatia on the far side. A very tense battle between Belgium and Switzerland for third position on the grandstand side, with Pooley and Stevenson back in fifth for Great Britain.
だいぶ横風も強くなってきて、ちょっと漕ぎにくいコンディションになってきました。イタリアがそれにもかかわらず非常に力強いフィニッシュで水を突き放してリードを広げていようとしています。それに続いてクロアチア、ルーマニアとスイスが非常に競って3位争いを繰り広げています。
We're going through 1500 and there's beginning to be some changes because the Croatians have seized the opportunity to try and overhaul Italy. That's a monumental effort because there were some two lengths in it back along. Now just three quarters and the Croatian charge continues. They for their part, the Belgians have taken a three quarter of a length lead on Switzerland despite the fact that the Swiss are overrating the Belgians and the Belgian charge continues and that pressure from the leading pack has drawn them further ahead of Great Britain in fifth.
イタリアがちょっと、力強い漕ぎに陰りが見えてきたように思います。それに引き換ええー、クロアチア、ルーマニアが、すみません、ベルギーが非常に、力強い漕ぎで追い上げています。
Well, 2:50 to go, and the Italians have suddenly woken up to the fact they've got a race in their hands. They were dominating this race throughout the outset. They were content to take the rate down a little, but the pressure from behind, Croatia and Belgium still closing with a 150 left to go.
Yeah, Italy really having to put in quite a lot of work now, 36 strokes a minute to hold off Croatia and Belgium, either side of them, absolutely level into the last 100 metres.
1着を行きますのは3レーンのイタリア、そして奥のクロアチアが2着、そして3着がベルギーと続いています。
Last couple of strokes, Italy are going to maintain their lead across the line. Pressure did come down, but it looks as though Belgium takes second place, a canvas up on Croatia on the far side. Those three crews nonetheless safe to progress through to the AB semi-final, and that means that Switzerland leads the way into the repechage.Along with Great Britain coming in for fifth place. So we'll see them all race again following that last, third and last heat for the men's pair.
準決勝 AB に進むのはイタリア、クロアチア、ベルギーの3カ国、そしてスイスとイギリスは敗者復活戦に挑みます。To the good old days, when the mama sang us to sleep, but now we're stressed out.We could turn back time to the good old days.
We move on now to the first heat for the women's quadruple sculls. It's another five-boat lineup here. Canada in lane one, Austria in two, France in lane three, Switzerland in lane four, and the Netherlands in lane five.
女子クオドルプルの予選が始まっています。こちらの予選は6組行われます。現在第1組、1レーンカナダ、2レーンオーストラリア、3レーンフランス、4レーンスイス、5レーンオランダです。
So they're already passing through the 1000 meters now. Switzerland out in front, not by much though. Camilla, it looks like we've got quite a race on our hands here.
Indeed, hugely tight one here, Pete, through the 1,000 metre marker. We've had a lot of chopping and changing for positions, but Switzerland coming out on top for the moment ahead of Canada, who are about three quarters of a length back. They in turn fighting between Netherlands and in the middle of the course, France, for that third place position through to the AB semi-final. And I really can't call it at this point who's got that third between the Dutch and the French.
4レーンカナダ、4レーンスイスがリード、1レーンカナダが追う展開です。このレース女子クオドルプル予選、準決勝に進出するのは3艇ですので、この4艇の中から3艇のみが準決勝に進みます。非常に争いが厳しくなってまいりました。
Wow, what a push from the Canadians there. Up to 37 strokes a minute over in lane number one. They've now pulled themselves up to half a length now behind the Swiss crew, last year's gold medalist. Only one returner from that crew, Celia Dupree, in the stroke seat, leading them down the course here in this first heat of the junior women's quads. But this race between France and the Netherlands is just stunning. The Dutch crew, bronze medalist from last year's event, and at the momentTrying to make their way even into the AB semi-finals is a tough call. We're approaching 1500 metres now, so 500 metres to go. And this Canadian push just isn't going away here for the Swiss out in front. They're still at half a length, putting pressure on. And the two crews in third and fourth, down at three quarters of a length back on the two leading crews.
非常に僅差な争いが展開されております。トップを行くスイス、ストローク、デュプレ選手は、昨年この種目で優勝している選手です。小柄ですが非常に力強いストロークで、クルーをリードしています。第2位にいるカナダ、昨年バウペアが、このレース6位になっています。カナダのフラッグシップのボートです。非常に、きつい争いになっております。
A little bit of a look there from the Dutch crew. They know they need to move now if they want to solidify that third and final place through to the AB semi-final. And they have managed now to get just a canvas ahead of the French crew, pushing them back into fourth. But this Swiss crew also in danger here for the lead. I think Canada now just starting to move on the far side of the course. They've seen the marker for 250 metres to go. They're still up at 37 strokes a minute and closing in. These two crews will want to have the better of one another, leading into the next stage of this race. And what a race here in the AB, for the AB semi-final spots, Pete.
Switzerland out in front, 37 strokes a minute. Nobody's going to touch them, but this sprint from the Canadians on the far side, 39 strokes a minute. Maya Meshkulate really pumping it up for a fast sprint finish.
先頭を行くのはスイス、2着争いが熾烈です。カナダとオランダが最後ラストスパートです。
Last couple of strokes, Switzerland might just maintain this lead, but pressure has built here with the Dutch on the near side pulling up alongside Canada. So Switzerland take the win, a quarter of a length ahead of Canada, who have 2 feet on the Netherlands. That's the 1-2-3 progressing through to the AB semi-final. Fourth place in the centre lane there, France ahead of fifth place Austria. They will race through the repechage.
2レーンのオーストリアが最後、まもなくゴールラインを割ろうというところでしょうか。女子クオドルプル予選1組目、1レーンカナダが、こちらが2着ですね、1着が4レーンのスイス、2着が1レーンのカナダ、3着に入りましたのが5レーンのオランダ、こちらの3カ国が準決勝 AB に進みます。そして3レーンのフランス、2レーンのオーストリアが敗者復活戦に挑みます。
The second heat now for the women's quadruple sculls, just going through 800 metres. We've got the USA in lane one, Italy in two, Japan in lane three, the Czech Republic in four, and China in lane five.
女子クオドルプル予選2組目です。 1レーンアメリカ、2レーンイタリア、3レーンに日本、川村麻鈴、加藤沙耶香、松田恭子、中澤遥香、そして4レーンにチェコ、5レーン中国です。
So they're just going through the 1000 meters and out in front at the moment we got the Czech Republic leading ahead of China, but not by much here, Robert.
By much here, Robert.
Yeah, so it's a real battle of experience versus youth and on their side the Chinese with four newcomers to international competition are really pressurizing the experienced Czechs. Three members of that crew came out of last year's gold medal eight. They've been joined by Simona Paskova in the stroke seat from the Bless Club in Prague. It was that quad that were making all the early running, but half a length back is China. Then a further two-thirds of a length back, it's Italy holding on to the third qualifying slot ahead of the USA and Japan.
日本チームの初陣を切って女子のクォートルプルが力走しております。ストロークの中澤さんは
But these two boats now just ticking it over at 35, 36 strokes a minute into this last 100 meters.
一着を引きますのが4レーンのチェコ。こちらは一定差以上上げているのでこのままセーフティーリードというところのニュージーランド。そして2着争いが熾烈となっております。3着までに入ると予選準決にそのまま進みます。
So coming out to the line, New Zealand, we know have the win. Germany looking good for second, but it's so, so close between Great Britain and Romania. It's on the surge of the stroke. Great Britain take third place, just under a foot ahead of Romania across the line. That's how I saw it. So we will have to wait for the official result to confirm it. But New Zealand won that in 6:36.38. Germany second. And then in a few moments, we'll have that official result to confirm whether Great Britain or Romania progressed through. I saw it as Great Britain by a foot.
女子クォドルプル予選3組目1着で通過したのはニュージーランド2着がドイツそして3着がイギリス最後いい追い上げを見せたルーマニアは4着で敗者復活戦に挑みます
So just before we move on to that next race, I can confirm that New Zealand, Germany and Great Britain go through to the AB semi-final from that third heat of the women's quadruple sculls. We'll see Romania in the repechage. Now the next race, the first heat for the men's quadruple sculls has started where we've got the People's Republic of China in lane one, United States of America in two, New Zealand in lane three, Japan in four, India in lane five and Romania in lane six.
男子クォドルプル予選第1組目はスタートしています1レーン中国2レーンアメリカ3レーンニュージーランド4レーンに日本大下春人島田俊介青木宏樹阿部浩二の4人ですそして5レーンにインド6レーンルーマニア
Well they're just passing through the thousand so let's find out from Robert the positions
Thanks, Pete. And as you join us at the halfway mark, it's the New Zealanders dominating this by about a length ahead of the field. William Thompson in the stroke seat, the sole survivor from last year's seventh place crew. They're leading the Romanians in second position. Over on the far side in third, China and the USA pretty much level, about a length ahead of Japan in fifth position and India sixth.
日本男子、クォドルプルスカル、満を持して、出場してきました、今のところ、4位につけています、クルー編成としては3番の青木くんが、JOC エリートアカデミー出身の高校3年生それ以外の3人は大学1年生のクルーで、挑んでいます、体は平均的にはちょっと外人に劣って小さいと思いますけれども、まあ、順風で、軽量の日本人にとっても十分、勝機のある
Well, don't forget the qualification rules for this event change. It's only the leading two across the line in the heat will go straight through to the semi-final. The other crews have another chance in the repechage later in the week. And right now, those slots being held by New Zealand and Romania. And that private battle between China and the USA over on the far side.Seems to be won by the Chinese who've moved up about a canvas into a clear third position, but they've got a long, long way to go, about a length and a quarter to come back on the second-placed Romanians who are charging on. They've seen pressure developing over on the far side of the course. They've raised their rate, and that has meant they've increased their overlap on the stern end of the New Zealanders.
ニュージーランドが依然として、リードを保って、2位にルーマニア、3位争いが熾烈になっています。中国とアメリカでしょうか。ただこのレースは2位までにしか、準決勝いけませんので、ちょっとここで逆転するのはちょっと難しい状況になっています。
The Romanians certainly no slouches. They're running a close second now behind New Zealand, but the Kiwis beginning to increase the pace yet again because they don't just want to win their heat here on the opening day of racing in Tokyo. They want to do it in style. And the New Zealanders really are punching in at 39 strokes a minute, the highest rating of any of these six quads on the water right now. The Romanian bowman glances across. Is he going to make a late charge? I very much doubt it. New Zealand leading the way, Pete.
Yeah, New Zealand domination here in this first heat for the men's quadruple sculls. They're certain for the win. Pressure's on, though, with the Americans pushing up, trying to draw level with China. We see New Zealand cross the line for the win. They're a length and a half ahead of Romania. And then China just maintaining three quarters of a length ahead of the USA. So China takes third, USA fourth. And then in the center lane here, we have Japan in fifth ahead of India for sixth place. So that means we will see New Zealand, Romania, and China progress through to the AB semi-final, and we'll see the rest again in that repechage.
予選1組目、1着でゴールしたのはニュージーランド、2着がルーマニア、そして3着、最後引き離したのは中国、ここまでが準決勝に進みます。そして4着、アメリカ、5着、日本、そして6着、インドが敗者復活戦に挑みます。
On now to the second heat for the men's quadruple sculls, where we've got Chile in lane one, Germany in two, France in lane three, Russia in lane four, Great Britain in five, and Canada in lane six.
男子クォドルプル予選2組目、1レーンチリ、2レーンドイツ、3レーンフランス、4レーンロシア、5レーンイギリス、6レーンカナダです。
Coming through 750 meters, the lead trading places now, Camilla. Looks like Germany have just stolen it from Russia.
Indeed, Pete. Russia, the early leaders here, but arguably the favourites on paper. Germany now just starting to show form. I think they're very, very tight, though, up at the front. If anything, Russia's still trying to cling on to that lead. But the Germans, three bronze medalists from last year in Rachice, 2018, the middle pair, Finger and Perkov from the quad, and then the stroke man from the eight, and they're now just starting to settle into their middle race pace at 36 strokes a minute in comparison to Russia's 35, and trying to contend there for the lead.
男子クォドルプル予選、このレースでは2艇のみが準決勝に進みます。3位争い、2位争いから3位争いのところが非常に重要な意味を持ちます。第2レーン、ドイツは昨年銅メダルを獲得しているメンバーが3人乗っています。強豪ドイツにあってジュニアの代表になるだけでも大変なのですが、昨年から代表を組んでいる、そういうメンバーが乗っている非常にドイツとしても力の入っているそういうクルーになります。ロシア、ドイツが1位を争う展開、3位にカナダ。
So as we're well into this third 500 meters now, the boat speed from the German crew just looks that little bit quicker as they take pole position ahead of the early leading Russian crew. They just seem to let the boat run underneath them that little bit longer than the Russians, even though they're rating that one pip higher. And these two crews at the moment contending for the only two slots through to the AB semi-finals. The best of the rest, well, at the moment, that is Canada, coached by Patrick Cody. This crew sitting third position with overlap onto the Russian boat. They've got about a quarter of a length of overlap, but not enough, sadly, at the moment to put them through to that AB semi-final. Starting to show in fourth is now Great Britain.
前半で大きなリードを奪っていたロシアですが、そのリードを使い果たして、ドイツがそれを追い抜こうというところです。ロシアとしては、3位のカナダをなんとか抑えにかかりたいところです。3位のカナダは予選通過ポジションである2位になんとか食い込みたいというそういうローイングになっております。4位の、イギリス、第1レーンのチリにもまだチャンスがあると思われます。 第1レーンのチリは昨年6位のメンバーそのまま、編成したまま、今年の選手権にチャレンジしています。
Well, the Russians not leaving the Germans alone out at the front of the field. They've come right back into this race for first. And the two Baubles now just gliding along at the same pace. They're both at 35 strokes a minute, both Germany and Russia. And really nothing to tell between those two Baubles. And as we come into 250 meters to go, I think just about Germany at the moment ahead of Russia. But we'll have to see what pace they've got into the final sprint. Great Britain now coming into third position alongside Canada. A big push from them there as they can see 30 strokes to go. And they've now moved into third place ahead of Canada in fourth and China in fifth. Pete, this is going to be close for the lead here in this heat of the junior men's quads.
Yeah, we've got two races going on here. Germany trying to hold out ahead of Russia, but Great Britain just moving through Canada. Miles Devereux in the stroke seat, pumping it up to 39. The Canadians respond. William Simpson in the stroke seat there goes up to 41.
現在1着行くのは2レーンのドイツ、そしてロシアが続いています。この2着取りで次の準決勝に進みます。
So coming up to the line, Germany looking good for the win, but not by much. And then Great Britain level with Canada. So crossing the line here, Germany a canvas ahead of Russia, and then Great Britain maybe an inch ahead of Canada. That's how I saw it, but we'll certainly have to wait for the official result on that one because Canada were just surging on the stroke there towards the line. Fifth place was Chile on the far side ahead of sixth place France. So it's only two to go through to the semi-final. So we know that that will be Germany and Russia. But a great sprint finish nonetheless from Great Britain and Canada. We will see them along with Chile and France progress through to the repêchage.
男子クオドルプル予選2組目。1着で通過したのはドイツ、そして2着がロシア。この2カ国が準決勝に進みます。3着で通過イギリス、4着カナダ、5着にチリ、6着にフランス、こちらが敗者復活戦に挑みます。
On now to the third and last heat for the men's quadruple sculls. We've got a five-boat lineup this time with Italy in lane one, Austria in two, Switzerland in lane three, the Czech Republic in four, and the Netherlands in lane five.
男子クオドルプル予選3組目。1レーンイタリア、2レーンオーストリア、3レーンスイス、4レーンチェコ、5レーンオランダ。
600 meters in and out in front, Italy dominating this race by convincing margin. But Robert, have they gone out too soon?
Well, isn't it interesting, Pete, that when you get to a junior world championships, a lot of the crews come into this particular regatta with pedigree on their side, having competed at previous world championships or maybe even senior world cups earlier in the season. But others come straight in with no previous international experience. And it's that tense battle between those two groups that is one of the most exciting things for me, at least. But as we move down towards the halfway mark in this third heat of the junior men's quads, it is Italy holding on to that narrow lead. An inexperienced crew, four athletes coming new to the junior world championships. The Netherlands, who are running them a close second on the grandstand side, bags of experience on that on board there. The two guys in the bow pair, Guus Mollet and Felix Mabius, out of last year's Netherlands eight. The whole lineup coached by the legendary Ronald Florin, double Olympic gold medalist in the double scull and the men's eight for the Netherlands. But the Netherlands now coming under pressure from the Czech Republic, another experienced lineup. And now, even as I've been describing the scene, the Czechs move narrowly into the second qualifying position.
クオドルプルスカル、予選第3組、図らずしもこの組は全てヨーロッパの強豪国が揃いました、今後 U23 シニアのカテゴリーでも、競い合う ライバル同士の対決になっています。その中でイタリアが、力強い漕ぎと、伝統的なハイレートで、差を広めています。オランダ、3位にちょっと落ちてきましたが、途中でちょっと水を叩いてオールの、ミスオールがあったように見受けられます。2位には、チェコが、判定審、オランダを抑えて、リードしています。3位争いが非常に熾烈になっています。
1,250 metres gone and the position's unchanged. It's still the Italians who are making the charge. They are length up on the Czech Republic. I mentioned the experience on board that particular lineup, the bow pair out of last year's bronze medal double scull, partnering with two athletes out of the four and the eight from last year. And that tactical move they made at the halfway mark to overhaul the Netherlands, well, that was a push that I didn't see happening in this particular opening heat. And these three leaders, well, they're moving away. Another little private battle developing between the inexperienced Austrians in lane two and Switzerland in lane three, who are still pretty much level.
最後の、ラストスプリントに入ってきました、イタリアはだいぶ、余裕を持って漕いでいるように見受けられます、3位の、オランダが2位の、チェコを追い上げようとしていますがちょっと漕ぎが小さくなってきてちょっと差が若干広がってきているような感じを受けます。
Well, there's about 300 metres left to run of this third heat of the junior men's quads, and I don't see the positions changing now because the Netherlands, after making that running and pushing Italy pretty hard through the first half of the race, once they were overhauled by the Czech Republic, the heart seemed to go out of them. Yes, they are together, a very synchronous unit, as one might expect, being coached by Florin, but they've upped the rate. They're trying to come back on the Czech Republic, but I suspect it's all too late for that. 150 meters to go, and Italy leads the Czech Republic for the two qualifying slots.
Yeah, the Netherlands going up to 43 strokes a minute. David van Velden doing his best to close in on the Czechs, but I think they're just going to run out of water to try and get into one of the two places into the AB semi.
先頭を行くのはイタリア、一定差以上を開けてこちらセーフティーリードでしょうか。2着続くのはチェコ、3着にオランダが続いています。
So coming across the line, Italy take the win in this third and last heat for the men's quads, a length ahead of the Czech Republic. So those two go through to the AB semi. Just missing out, the Netherlands take third place here, ahead of Switzerland for fourth, and then coming in for fifth, Austria. They'll go through to the repêchage.
男子クオドルプル予選3組目、1着で通過したのはイタリア、2着がチェコ。この2カ国が準決勝 AB に進みます。そして3着、オランダ、4着、スイス、5着、オーストリアです。
We move from the quads on now to the first heat for the men's double sculls, where we've got a six-boat lineup here: Sobe Safaroliev and Davrion Davronov for Uzbekistan in lane one. And then in lane two for Zimbabwe, Patrick and Rory Plunkett, twins from Zimbabwe, in lane two. Wang Qingyan and Sun Bo for the People's Republic of China in lane three. Rikuto Sugawara and Senosuke Nakayo for Japan in lane four. Hamish Henriquez and Harrison Fox for Australia in five. And then completing the field for Greece in lane six, Vasileios Baroutas and Dimitrios Stasinos.
男子ダブルスカル、こちらは予選で4組行われます。現在第1組が進んでいます。1レーンウズベキスタン、2レーンジンバブエ、3レーン中国、4レーンに日本、菅原陸斗、中条千之助、5レーンオーストラリア、6レーンギリシャです。
So they're just coming out towards 800 meters in. Australia are out in front at the moment and looking to really build a solid margin here. It's a tough progression system though, Camilla. Only one to go through.
Definitely, Pete. And with only one boat to go through, I think Australia really have it in their minds. They want to be in that position where they don't have to race the repêchage later on this week. But from lane number five, Australia now stroked by Harrison Fox, the Melbourne University Boat Club sculler, currently in the lead by clear water currently over the next boat back, which comes from Zimbabwe in lane number two. These twins have been sculling together now for some time, Rory Plunkett and Patrick Plunkett, both born on the 11th of March 2001, making them twins. Currently sit in second position ahead of Greece by a length, and Greece holding down third by clear water over a great fight that's going on at the back of the field between China and Uzbekistan.
オーストラリアが大きなリードを奪っております。男子ダブルスカル予選、このレースからは一定のみが準決勝に進出します。オーストラリアの優位は揺るがないというところでしょう。
第2レーンのジンバブエ、あまりローイングでの世界では聞かれない名前ではありますが、このプランケット兄弟、彼らは双子です。長いことダブルスカルを組んで良いコンビネーション、これを武器に戦いたいところですが、この予選通過は非常に厳しいかというところです。日本のクルーは成長菅原陸斗、福井三方高校、バウ中条千之助、成立学園、双方とも2年生、若いクルーでのチャレンジです。
As we go through 750 meters to go, Australia now starting to look really comfortable. They're still at rate 36. They're not dropping the rating by any more than that, but they have got about three lengths of clear water back to the Zimbabwean double over on the far side of the course. From if you're here watching in the grandstands, if you're listening in online, Zimbabwe currently in second ahead of Greece in third, still positions remaining unchanged. And that great fight between China and Uzbekistan still really tight there at the moment. I think it is just about China coming into third position ahead of Uzbekistan, and unfortunately the home favourites from Japan off the back trailing in sixth, but the leaders undoubtedly at the moment are Australia.
第1位のオーストラリア、予選通過は揺るがないというところで余裕を持ったローイングです。日本は今現在第6位を超えております。アジアのライバルであるウズベキスタン、中国に対しても遅れを取っております。ここをなんとか挽回してアジアの中での順位でも上げていきたいところです。敗者復活戦への、作戦もすでに頭の中に、各クルーあるかもしれません。
Well spreadfield here in this first heat of the junior men's double scull. Australia dominating from start to finish, and as we come into the final 250 metres, a final push called there by Hamish Henriquez in the bow seat, bronze medalist from last year's men's Cox 4 for Australia, now here with two blades in the double scull, making a really good job of leading this field in the first heat.
Yeah, they've had a great race throughout. 37 strokes a minute, they've been the fastest boat all the waydown the course, even in their low patches rather than when they're sprinting now. So they've pumped it up to 38 strokes a minute, really trying to wind it up for a fast finish here ahead of the current second place Zimbabwean combination of Patrick and Rory Plunkett, who are holding comfortably onto second place, but it's only one boat to go through and the Aussies look to have sewn it up.
最初から先頭を引きますとオーストラリアはセーフティーリードというところでしょうか。こちら一着取りで準決勝に進みます。
So Australia's Harrison Fox and Hamish Henriquez take the win here in this first heat for the men's doubles, comfortably ahead of Zimbabwe's Patrick and Rory Plunkett, which means that we'll see Australia go straight through to the AB semi-final. Everyone else will see race again in the repechage as we see Greece cross the line for third place ahead of China coming in for fourth. Fifth will be Uzbekistan and then completing the field Japan for sixth.
男子ダブルスカル予選第1組、1着で通過したのはオーストラリア。こちらが準決勝 AB に進みます。2着がジンバブエ、3着ギリシャ、4着中国、5着ウズベキスタン、6着が日本です。
they're showing no signs of giving up despite the monumental task they've set themselves. And in fact, the Russians, who are still a pip lower than Austria, are drawing further and further ahead. And there must be almost two lengths in it between first and second, with 300 meters remaining of this second heat of the junior men's double sculls. The pressure from that leading competition, as ever, has seen them draw ahead of Laurie and Dexter for the USA back in third. But inside the last 250, the red boy zone that marks the finish of a 2,000 meter international rowing course, it's still Domashev and Vasin leading the way to the line, Pete.
Yeah, they've had a great race here. 32 strokes. I mean, it just shows the power in this combination from Russia, holding such a great boat speed at just 32. Austria trying to wind it up, though. Fabian Gilhofer and Konrad Hulsch, they've gone to 34, but they've got too much water to try and close in on the leaders from Russia.
1着先頭を引きますのは2レーンのロシア。こちらかなり大きく差を分けて1着で進んでいきます。2着続くのはオーストリア。1着との差は20メートル以上というところでしょうか。
Gil Dexter and Peter Lowry for the USA putting in a really solid sprint on the far side. 38 strokes a minute to try and put in their best effort here in the last 100 meters. As we see Dmitry Domashev and Anton Vashin take the win for Russia and that one and only place through to the AB semi-final. Second place, we have Hulsch and Gilhofer for Austria ahead of the USA, Peter Lowry and Gil Dexter. Fourth place in the center lane there, Sturla, Mogstad and Frederik Reiter for Norway. Ahead of, on the near side, Mihailovs and Sills for Latvia in fifth. And then in sixth place for Singapore, Mladenic and Van Brussel. So we'll see them all race again in that repechage.
男子ダブルスカル予選2組目1着で通過したのはロシア。こちらが準決勝に進みます。2着以下オーストラリア、失礼しました、2着オーストリア、アメリカ、ノルウェー、ラトビア、シンガポールが敗者復活戦に回ります。
Third heat now for the men's double sculls. Konrad Zielagyi and Bence Szlenka for Hungary in lane one. Narong Sak Nangseng and Piapong Anunamang for Thailand in lane two. Kobe Miller and Scott Shackleton for New Zealand in lane three. Matteo Sartori and Niccolo Carucci for Italy in lane four. Benjamin Hagenauer and Romain Harat for France in five. And then completing the field for Estonia in lane six, Leo Miskte and Mark Theodore Jakalas.
男子ダブルスカル予選3組目すでにスタートしております。1レーンハンガリー、2レーンタイ、3レーンニュージーランド、4レーンイタリア、5レーンフランス、6レーンエストニアです。
This race now passing through halfway. Camilla, Italy out in front. Can anybody catch these fast moving Italians?
I was just thinking to myself, actually, Pete, I don't think anyone can touch this combination of Carucci and Sartori here in lane number four for Italy. They've now got about a length of clear water over France and New Zealand, who sit in third, but only just ahead of this experienced Hungarian combination back again after winning the B final last year in Rečice. A little bit further back, we've then got Thailand in fifth ahead of Estonia in sixth.
Dance double scuttle.予選第3組、一艇のみが準決勝に上がるというシビアなレースです、第1位はイタリア。非常に力強いストローク、非常に長くて力強いストローク、大きく水を開けて第2位第3位を引き離しております。第2位争いをするのはフランス、ニュージーランド、ニュージーランドは、高校2年生世代のフラッグシップボートということで将来性を買ってのこのレースへの参加です。アジア、から参加の第2レーンタイ、かなり良い争いをしております、予選通過は厳しいところですが第2位争いに食い込もうというところです。
The Italians still up at rate 36. Nicolo Carucci just setting an absolutely phenomenal pace here. They look so, so strong out in front as they approach the 500 metres to go marker. They put even more distance between themselves and France, who currently sit in second position, half a length up on the New Zealand combination from Christchurch Boys High School and Blenheim Rowing Club over in New Zealand. A new combination that's come together, and they currently sit in third, half a length back on France. It's then really tight over on the far side still between Hungary and Thailand. Hungary about half a length up on the Thai crew in lane number two.
第1位イタリア、非常に力強い漕ぎを続けています。予選通過はほぼ確実というところですが、緩めることなく、力強いストロークを刻んでいます。明日の敗者復活戦、失礼しました、明後日の敗者復活戦を経て、準決勝まで2日間の休みがありますが、そのことを、特に意識をしない、非常に力強いローイングです。第2位にフランスですが、3停身近くの差がありますので、非常に、これを捉えるのは厳しいところかと思われます。
So as the Italians come into the final 250 metres now, they're just running at a consistent pace. In fact, actually, the two crews either side of them, France and New Zealand, moving at the same boat speed now as we enter the final 200 metres. But I don't think anyone's going to catch the Italians, Pete.
Yeah, Italy looking so good. Matteo Sartori, Nicola Carucci out in front, 34 strokes a minute, but we've got a bit of a race developing behind them as we see on the far side, Thailand, Hungary, trying to close in on New Zealand.
スタートからリードを許すことのないイタリア、こちらはそのまま1着で通過でしょうか。2着以降、こちら2着と3着は抜きつ離れつ、フランスとニュージーランドを行われていたのですが、別の3点も迫っています。
Italy coming in to take the win in this third of four heats for the men's double sculls. They cross the line a length and a half ahead of France. So Italy go through to the AB semi-final. Second place France, third New Zealand, fourth Thailand, justHalf a canvas ahead of Hungary for fifth place, and then on the near side, Estonia for sixth.
男子ダブルスカル予選3組目、1着で通過したのはイタリア。こちらが準決勝 AB に進みます。2着通過フランス、3着ニュージーランド、4着にタイ、5着ハンガリー、6着エストニアでした。
Fourth and last heat now for the men's double sculls, already well underway here. We got Vita Moreau and Sjord Schepper for the Netherlands in lane one, Thomas Levy and Breno Felix for Brazil in two, Koma Burutaran and Caetano Horta Pombo for Spain in lane three, Titas Mašanauskas and Virgilijus Pružinskas for Lithuania in four, Paul Kruger and Aaron Afanian for Germany in lane five, and completing the field, Oliver Skovjerkovic and Nicholas Andersen for Denmark in lane six.
男子ダブルスカル予選最終組です。4組目、1レーンオランダ、2レーンブラジル、3レーンスペイン、4レーンリトアニア、5レーンドイツ、6レーンデンマークです。
So they're already through 1250, so we'll jump straight to it with Robert.
Yes, and we've seen quite a tense battle between Spain and Germany through the firstHalf of this fourth heat of the junior men's doubles. But now Paul Kruger and Aaron Erfanian for Germany have put their foot on the gas and have taken clear water ahead of the rest of the field. Spain in second place, the Brazilians in third ahead of Netherlands, Denmark and Lithuania.
ダブルスカルの予選、4組、この種目はやっぱり出走数が非常に多いので、予選の組も多くなっています。レースではドイツが、他の競艇を1停止以上リードを奪っております。2位にスペインは非常にこの種目、特にダブルスカル小艇に力を入れているのか、強いクルーが、出てきております。3位にブラジルに関しても、U23若い世代で、世界大会で入賞するクルーが最近出てきているような印象を受けます。
Through the 1500 meters mark, Kruger and Erfanian maintaining their lead. certainly the favourites on paper for this heat, and certainly one of the favourites, I suspect, for the title at the end of the week. Paul Kluger in the bow seat. He is the reigning world champion in this boat class with his previous partner, and now with Erfanian out of the bronze medal quad from last year, and they have absolutely destroyed the field. They've now got two lengths of clear water inside the last 250. But the best of the rest are still Spain, hanging on to second place ahead of the newcomers from Brazil, who are in third. A late charge from Denmark on the grandstand side sees them squeeze ahead of the Netherlands, with Lithuania six with 150 to go, Pete.
Yeah, Germany looking so good out in front. Paul Kruger and Aaron Afanian leading the way here for that one place through to the AB semi-final. 33 strokes a minute. They almost look as though they've eased off coming into the last 150 metres.
先頭を行くのはドイツ、続いてスペイン、ブラジル、デンマークが続いています。このままゴールライン割ります。どのような感じでゴールしましたか？
So, last few strokes now, and we're going to see Germany take the win here in this fourth heat for the men's double sculls. They've got a length and a half up on Spain towards the line, and then we've got a real sprint for Denmark on the near side. Germany crossed the line for the win. We've then got Spain coming in for second, and on the near side, Denmark's sprint has paid off. They take third, half a length ahead of Brazil, and then we've got fifth place, the Netherlands, ahead of sixth place, Lithuania.
男子ダブルスカル予選4組目、1着でゴールしたのはドイツ。ドイツが準決勝 AB に進みます。そして2着がスペイン、3着が最後いい追い上げを見せましたデンマーク、4着にブラジル、5着オランダ、6着リトアニアです。
So we move from the men's to the first heat for the women's double sculls, where we've got Evangelina Fraku and Evangelina Anastasiadou for Greece in lane one, Marina Tsalko and Tsenia Slonova for Russia in lane two, Jette Prem and Judith Huse for Germany in lane three, Anna Navarro and Uria Jarama Diaz for Spain in lane four, Cheng Chuk Wang and Poon Ouyou for Hong Kong, China in lane five, and then Lauren Henry and Olivia Morgan for Great Britain in lane six.
女子ダブルスカル予選は4組あります。現在すでに1組目がスタートしています。1レーンギリシャ、2レーンロシア、3レーンドイツ、4レーンスペイン、5レーン香港、6レーンイギリスです。
Well, we're 1,000 meters in. It's looking good, like a good start here for Camilla for Spain, but there's so many boats trying to close them in, and it's only a length separating them, I think.
Between the first four crews in this first heat of the junior women's double sculls. At the moment, Spain in the lead, but really hotly contested by Greece over in lane number one. We've also got Germany sitting in third ahead of Great Britain in fourth, and with only one qualifying spot through to the AB semi-final, it could all change later on down this course.
女子ダブルスカル予選、1クルーのみが準決勝に進出します。1位スペインがややリード、しかし2位争いも非常に熾烈になっています。第1位に迫ろうというところです。やや横風のコンディション、難しいコンディションになってまいりました。直進を、船の直進を保つだけでも大変な状況になっております。この中で第1位のスペイン、やや前半飛ばしてきたことがたたっているか、第2位、第3位、第4位ギリシャ、ドイツ、イギリスからややプレッシャーを受けている状況です。
Well, it's all closing up here again as the Greek crew close in on Spain up at the front of the field. Only a quarter of a length now that the Spanish crew have got in the lead, and the Greeks moving quickly at 38 strokes a minute. They know they've not got long, just over 500 metres to go, and the British going with them as well. A little look there by Lauren Henry in the bow seat of the British crew. If you're tuning in from Leicester Rowing Club, I'm sure you're proud to hear that, that the British crew moving up quickly.Now, but still the Greeks now move into the lead. What a great little push there from them with 500 meters to go. A fantastic turn of pace to overhaul Spain in the lead, and the British now trying to move through into second and overturn Spain.
予選通過のたった一つの席をめぐっての争い、非常にシビアになっています。
リードしてきたスペインがやや遅れを取り始めているか、ギリシャが非常に調子よくここでスピードを上げています。手前のイギリス、やや風下でコンディションの厳しいところを V に近づいて方向の修正にやや手間取っているところ。
This is stunning stuff here in the first heat of the Junior Women's Double Scull. Less than half a canvas to choose between the leading three crews. At the moment, still Greece in the lead, but having to fight hard between Great Britain, who now move into the lead as well. With every single stroke, it changes between Great Britain, Greece and Spain, with only one spot through into the AB semi-final. This is going to be a tough one, Pete.
Yeah, we need some volume in the grandstand here because they're going to be able to hear you now as they come into the last 200 metres. We've got three boats absolutely neck and neck. Great Britain, Greece and Spain. Nothing to split them as Greece build into this finishing sprint. Now 40 strokes a minute there. Anastasiadou really trying to wind it up for a fast sprint alongside Spain and GB.
準決勝に進めるのは1艇のみ。1着、すごい争いを繰り広げています。イギリスとギリシャ、スペイン。今はギリシャが一着でゴールしようというところでしょうか。
We can see Lauren Henley in the bow seat of the Great Britain boat looking over. They know they're absolutely level. It's going to be on the surge of the stroke across the line, and we see Greece take the win, just a fraction of a canvas, if that, ahead of Great Britain for second. Third place is Spain, fourth Germany, and then coming in for fifth, we have Russia ahead of Hong Kong, China.Sixth place. So Greece take the one spot through to the AB semi-final. We'll see everybody else again in the repêchage.
女子ダブルスカル予選1組目、1位でゴールしたのはギリシャ。こちらが準決勝 AB に進みます。すごい戦いでした。2着以降はイギリス、2着がイギリスでした。
Well now, we call this the act of mating, but...There are several other very important differences between human beings and animals.
The second heat now for the women's double sculls coming down quickly down the course here. We've got Barocca Elek and Flora Galsko for Hungary in lane one. Zhang Hairong and Zhang Peibing for China in lane two. Sophie Houston and Claire Netherway for Australia in lane three. Mana Takai and Mari Kori for Japan in lane four. Aileen Ibarra Maduena and Monica Garcia for Mexico.In lane five, and then completing the field, Una Yazinaite and Dovila Rimkute for Lithuania in lane six.
女子ダブルスカル予選2組目すでにスタートしています。1レーン、ハンガリー、2レーン、中国、3レーン、オーストラリア、4レーン、日本、武井真奈、郡麻里、5レーン、メキシコ、6レーン、リトアニアです。
Well, they're coming up towards 1200 meters, and Robert, it looks like China have gone after it in this second heat for the women's doubles.
They have indeed, Pete. Yes, another experienced crew, the stroke athlete, a world champion in this boat class from Rachite last year, partnering the bow athlete, Zhang Hairong, who、has taken part, believe it or not, in two World Cup regattas at senior level this year. Indeed, she was an A finalist at the opening regatta in Plovdiv. So they're seeking to dominate this second heat. They've got two lengths of clear water ahead of Lithuania.And、the crew over there in lane, excuse me, in lane five,、Lithuania hanging on to second.
女子のダブルスカル予選第2組、中国が、圧倒的なリードで、漕いでいます。中国は、海の森に入る前に、茨城県の潮来で合宿キャンプをしていたようで、その、コーチとして。イギリスで五輪で、5回金メダルを取ったレッドグレープが、コーチングしていると聞いています、中国のビッグマネーが動いたんでしょうか、2位争いは、リトアニア、オーストラリアですただこの中国との差はちょっと埋めるには非常に厳しい状況になってきています日本のクルー、ストロークの郡さん、文京学院女子高校、バウの武井さん、諏訪星稜高校この種目は、体力、以上にそのコンビネーションが非常に重要になってくる種目ですので、なんとか頑張って、コンビネーションを上げて少しでも差を縮めてほしいところです
1500 meters gone and the leading positions unchanged with China extending their lead and looking set for a place in the semi-final. The battle for second currently being won by the experienced Lithuanians unchanged from the lineup that took 14th place at last year's juniors, half a length up on Sophie Houston and Claire Netherway, the Australians in third position. Then there's a long, long gap of clear water before we get to Hungary in fifth and Mexico in sixth position. The leading contenders move inside the last 250 metres, and I suspect that China booked their place in the semi-final way back down this course. 200 metres to go, Pete.
Yeah, no discernible change in the rating or rhythm for China as they come into those red buoys. I think they're just going to tick it over still at their race rhythm of 33 strokes a minute into this last 200 metres. Confident that they'll be taking that one place through to the AB semi-final. A dominating performance from this young combination of Zhang Hairong and Zhang Peibing.
先頭からリードを保っているのが2レーンの中国。2着にはリトアニア、オーストラリアがこちら2艇が競っています。その後続いています。
So on their performance from this race, Zhang Hairong and Zhang Peibing, they'll be a combination to watch in the latter rounds of competition for the women's double sculls. As they cross the line taking the win, we then have Juzinaita Anarimkute for Lithuania taking second place, a length ahead of the Aussies Houston and Netherway for third. Coming in for fourth on the far side, we've got Elik and Galsko for Hungary, ahead of Japan's Take and Kori, who are winding it up for a bit of a sprint here, coming back in ahead of Mexico's Ibarra Maduena and Garcia, who will take sixth place.
女子ダブルスカル予選2組目、1着でゴールしたのは圧倒的な差を見せました中国。こちらが準決勝 AB に進みます。2着リトアニア、3着オーストラリア、4着ハンガリー、5着日本、6着に現在ゴールメキシコです。
Now on to the third heat for the women's double sculls, where we have Ida Blomstrand and Sophie Vickerso for Denmark in lane one, Erin Hallaby and Kelsey Gems for South Africa in lane two, Ida Kivik Sandvik and Caroline Berset for Norway in lane three, Belgium in lane four, Caitlin Covert and Jane Lenormand, and then completing the field for the USA in lane five, Delaney Evans and Taylor English.
女子ダブルスカル予選3組目すでにスタートしています。1レーンデンマーク、2レーン南アフリカ共和国、3レーンノルウェー、4レーンベルギー、5レーンアメリカ。
1,000 meters in and out in front, Caitlin Govert and Jeanne Lenormand leading the way. They've got a convincing margin already here, Camilla.
They do. They've led off the blocks and down here through halfway, but there is quite a chase going on behind them for second place. It was South Africa that sat in second, but the USA now challenging heavily for that position as they power away at rate 37 into this third 500 metres, along with Denmark also there at 34 strokes a minute in fourth. They're just being overhauled ever so slightly by these two crews, USA and South Africa for second, but the Belgians really going well out in front.
女子ダブルスカル予選第3組、1位のみが準決勝に進出いたします。ベルギーが大きなリードを奪って第1位を走っています。第2位にアメリカ、第3位に南アフリカ、第4位にデンマーク、第1位、それから第3位、ベルギーと南アフリカは、昨年の世界ジュニアを経験していない選手たちです。それ以外の3クルーは全員が、世界ジュニアをすで、に経験している、そういうレベルの高いレースが期待されました。その中で初めての世界ジュニアの、2クルーが非常に健闘しております。アメリカのクルーは非常に経験豊かなクルーなんですけれども、やや風に振られて風下側グランドスタンドに近い方へ船が振られているような、そういう動きになっています。ベルギーは安定して漕ぎ続けております。
So the Belgians still out in front, but a big kick here from the USA to try and establish themselves in second position and even close up the distance that Belgium have gained on them. An experienced combination here, both from Y Quad cities in the US, of a Taylor English and Delaney Evans here now with three quarters of a length over South Africa, who held second earlier on. These two crews now also pushing ahead of Denmark in fourth, an experienced combination that last year raced in the quad to get eighth place in Rachice, but here being led by three other crews.
1位ベルギー安定した攻撃を続けています。第2位のアメリカがやや迫ってまいりました。第3位南アフリカ、第4位デンマークはやや厳しいところか。横風が強い中ですが、やはりトップを走るベルギーの攻撃は安定して見えます。
Into the last 250 meters now, and not so long for the Belgian crew of Lennon and Govere to hold on to this lead that would put them into the AB semi-final. The US have closed the gap ever so slightly, but not enough, I don't think, to put them into that pole position. Over to you, Pete.
Thanks, Camilla. Yeah, the Belgians here, Govert and Lennon, leading at 34 strokes a minute, but the Americans have absolutely gone for it now. Delaney Evans and Taylor English go up to 38, 39 strokes a minute, desperately trying to close down that margin. They've still got a clear water gap to close if they want to get overlapped with the Belgians into this last 100 meters.
スタートからレースを引っ張るのは1着ベルギー、そしていいラストスパートを見せていますのが5レーンのアメリカ、3着争いが南アフリカ共和国とデンマークです。
Last few strokes, and we're going to see Caitlin Govert and Jeanne Lennon take the win in this third heat for the women's double sculls. Sprint emerging on the far side, though, as the South Africans really put the pressure on the USA up to the line. USA, I think, just hold on to it. Half a canvas ahead of South Africa, who have half a length ahead of Denmark for second, third, and fourth. And then coming in for
athletes came out of last year's bronze medal quad. They've got bags of experience on their side, and they are leading this field by clear water at the halfway mark. The pressure on the newcomers from Italy, Bonetto and Bozzio, on the grandstand side in lane five. They have half a length lead on Rhiannon O'Donoghue and Molly Carey for Ireland. Then back in fourth position, we've got Romania, who just lead Canada by a whisker.
女子ダブルスカル予選最後のレースです。1レーンのオランダが、3停止以上ですか、差をつけてリードを奪っています。風上にもかかわらず力強い漕ぎ、安定した漕ぎでリードを奪っています。残りのクルーは、ちょっと大きく水を分けられて逆転は難しくなっています。ヨーロッパの中で唯一カナダ、力走しています。個人的には、カナダには1年間、研究留学した経験もありますし、一緒に超えた経験もあります。コメンテーターの相棒の杉藤君もカナダでコーチング留学した経験もあるということで、2人とも心の中でちょっとカナダを応援しているところがあるのが正直なところです。
Well, the Netherlands still with this race well under control for their part back in third. Molly Curry has raised the Irish rate to 36, and they're beginning to overhaul the Italians, who I've still got down at 33 strokes a minute. No, even as I describe the scene, you can see them pushing out that stroke, really powering through on the finishes. Try and stave off the Irish attack with 1,500 metres go. But the Netherlands with, must be five lengths of clear water inside the last quarter.
The last sprint has come. The 1st of Holland is not going to be able to. Italy and Ireland are going to be.広げています。今後のレースにつながるという感じで、お互い手を抜かずに、ラストスパートを力強く漕いでいます。
some 350 metres remaining. Still Netherlands in the lead, but a great race for second. Curry and O'Donoghue up the rate yet again. Take it up to 37. The Italians are responding now, but I suspect that that push from Ireland is really pushing on so hard, and now overhauling Italy for the first time in this fourth heat of the junior women's doubles. And the pressure from those two crews has moved them through ahead of Romania, who continue and have extended their lead over Canada for fourth and fifth. Inside the closing stages then, the Netherlands all the way, Pete.
Well, I think every single women's doubles athlete or coach will be taking note of the performance here from Lisa Bronings and Jacobine van Vesteren. And what an incredible race from them, dominating the rest of the field by such a convincing margin. The Irish are sprinting now, though, and they're pulling to a safer lead ahead of Italy into the last 50.
先頭を行きますのは1着オランダ、50メートル以上の差をつけています。2着争いがアイルランドとイタリアです。
Last few strokes, and Fien van Vesteren and Lisa Bronings take the win here with perhaps 3.5 to 4 lengths of clear water ahead of Rhiannon O'Donoghue and Molly Curry for Ireland, who have just over a length ahead of Italy for third place. So the Netherlands progress directly through to the AB semi-final. Second place Ireland, third place Italy, ahead of fourth Romania and fifth Canada. We'll see them again in the repechage.
女子ダブルスカル予選4組目1着でゴールしたのはオランダ。オランダが準決勝 AB に進みます。そして2着最後にいいラストスパートを見せましたアイルランド、3着にイタリア、4着ルーマニア、5着カナダでした。
On to the single sculls next, and the first heat for the men's singles is underway. We've got Tim Roth for Switzerland in lane one, Andre Pinto for Portugal in two, Tristan van den Busch for Belgium in three, Joseph Wilber for Panama in lane four, and Brett Taylor for Chinese Taipei in lane five.
男子シングルスカル予選は4組あります。現在1組目がスタートしています。1レーンスイス、2レーンポルトガル、3レーンベルギー、4レーンパナマ、5レーン台湾です。
Halfway in already, and no surprise here, Camilla, to see Tristan van den Busch leading the way.
Indeed, last year's bronze medalist from Rachice out here in the lead at the front of this field from the middle of the course in lane number three, sculling absolutely beautifully. Tristan van den Busch with over a length lead now over the Swiss sculler on the far side, Tim Roth in lane number one. If you are tuning in from Switzerland at the moment, sat in a semi-final AB qualifying position over ahead of in lane number two, Portugal, we've got Andre Pinto currently sitting in third.
男子シングルスカル予選、これ2手上がりのレースです、2位と3位の争いが非常に厳しいというところです、第1位を行きますのはベルギーのトリスタン・バンデンブッシュ選手、昨年の銅メダリストです。体のブレのない非常に良いストロークでリードを奪っています。第4位にいるチャイニーズ・タイペイ、テイラー選手、彼はケンブリッジでトレーニング、イギリスのケンブリッジでトレーニングをしている選手です。第5位パナマ代表、彼はアメリカのフィラデルフィアベスパーロインクラブでのトレーニングをしているという選手です。
The Belgian sculler's rhythm at 34 strokes a minute, that little bit higher than Roth of Switzerland at rate 32. Roth of course out of the quad from last year for Switzerland that placed 9th in 2018, here now in the single sculler, muchSmaller boat to master, but as I said before, currently sitting in that important qualifying spot through to the AB semi-final. Tough to touch this very impressive Belgian sculler here. Tristan van den Busch still leading the way.
優勝候補、ベルギーのバンデンブッシュ選手、大変力強く安定したストロークで第4クォーターラストスパートに差し掛かろうというところです。第2位スイス、第3位ポルトガル、捉えるのは非常に厳しいかというところです。
So the chase is on at the moment for the Portuguese sculler Pinto. If he wants to get into that second place, he's got over a length and a half to make up now. He's raised the rating to rate 34 to try and get himself back on terms with Tim Roth of Switzerland in second place. But in turn, Tim Roth lowers the rating down to rate 30. I think he knows he's comfortably in second position behind the untouchable Tristan van den Busch. And as we move into the final 250 metres now, I think it would take a monumental effort from Pinto of Portugal to get himself into that AB semi-final ahead of the crews in the repechage. A little bit further back, best of the rest at the moment is coming from the sculler from Chinese Taipei in lane number 5 ahead of Panama.
200 metres to go and nobody can touch Tristan van den Busch for Belgium. We've seen him time and time again. Such a dominant athlete. He's dropped his rating to 29 into this last 150. He's got a safe clear water margin ahead of current second place Tim Roth for Switzerland.
先頭を引っ張るのは3レーンのベルギー。1点差以上開けてセーフティーリードというところでしょうか。2着取りということで、こちら2着が現在スイス、3着に行くのがポルトガルです。
Tristan van den Busch, last couple of strokes for him. He's going to take the win in this first heat for the men's single sculls with a nearly 2-length clear water margin ahead of Tim Roth for Switzerland in second place. So those two progress to the AB semi-final. Coming in for third, Andre Pinto for Portugal ahead of Joseph Wilbert and Brett Taylor. This is Brett Taylor for Chinese Taipei finishing up in fourth place ahead of Joseph Wilbert for Panama in fifth. So we'll see those two as well as Andre Pinto progress to the repechage.
男子シングルスカル予選1組目、1着でゴールしているのはベルギーです。2着でゴールしたのがスイス。この2カ国が準決勝 AB に進みます。3着がポルトガル、4着台湾、そして現在ゴールしました5着がパナマ。この3カ国が敗者復活戦に挑みます。
Second heat now for the men's singles. Nelson Mossetti for Kenya in lane 1. Hani Speita for Tunisia in lane 2. Mekrobe Mamatkulov for Uzbekistan in lane 3. Rares Andriy Necita for Cyprus in 4. And completing the field, Gennaro Di Mauro for Italy in lane 5.
男子シングルスカル予選2組目、すでにスタートしております。1レーンケニア、2レーンチュニジア、3レーンウズベキスタン、4レーンキプロス、5レーンイタリア。
Coming out through the 1,000 metres, Gennaro Di Mauro for Italy leading the way, which is no great surprise here, Robert, but good to see Necita holding on to second place, but potentially under pressure from Mamatkulov.
Yes, you're right, Pete. Di Mauro was always the favourite on paper for this opening heat here in Tokyo. An A finalist last year in Avacice, didn't win a medal on that occasion, but no doubt hoping to go one better by the end of the week. Gennaro Di Mauro then leads for Italy by clear water ahead of Necita for Cyprus out of last year's double that finished down the rankings in the Czech Republic. Mamatkulov for the Uzbekistan in third, back in fourth position. Spetia for Tunisia, followed by Mossetti of Kenya.
男子ダブルスカル第2組目、5レーンのイタリアが、リードを奪っているように見えます。ただちょっと C 逃げというかボディの連動がうまくいってないような漕ぎに見受けられますが、大きな体でなんとか船を進めているような印象を受けます。このレースでは1レーンケニア、2レーンチュニジアとアフリカ勢が漕いでいるのが非常に印象的です。ヨーロッパ、欧米を中心として行われているスポーツの中でこのアフリカ勢が入ってきているというのも非常にボートのグローバル化が進んできているというふうな印象を受けます。心肺能力的には非常に、いいものを持っているので、今後の組織的なトレーニングによっては非常に強豪国になる可能性を秘めていると思います。
Moving down towards 1500 meters, the position's unchanged. Di Mauro looking increasingly confident as this heat of the junior men's singles progresses. The Italian in his third successive junior world championships. He competed in track eye 2 years ago in Lithuania, where he competed as a member of the fifth-placed Italian eight. But the single skull is obviously where he likes to be. Well, to look out, because Nichita, the Cyprus athlete in the lane immediately to his left, somebody lit a fire under him, and he has come powering through because he's seen pressure develop from the Uzbekistan athlete. And I thought this race was all over bar the shouting, but we're 400 meters to go and there could be a big change. The Uzbek athlete is now moving through, but still hanging on to third.
Kypros が非常に安定したスムーズな漕ぎで、イタリアに迫っております。ただ一点進中差がありますので、なんとかイタリアが逃げ切ろうと必死になっている状況です。
Well, now Cheetah is having none of this. He's shaken off the Uzbek challenge. Now Matt Kulov has just tapped the rate right down, moving home inside the last 250. I thought we were going to see real fireworks there. Di Mauro leads the way for Italy ahead of Nichita for Cyprus.
And you can see the emphasis on every stroke that Rarezandra Nichita from Cyprus is putting in. He really is banging through every single one at 35 strokes a minute. Real power through the water, but not quite enough to close in on the margin that Gennaro Di Mauro holds for Italy out in front.
先頭を行くのは5レーンのイタリア。しかし4レーンのキプロスがいい追い上げを見せています。ラストスパート。大きく堂々としたラストスパートです。
Di Mauro is going to take the win here in this second heat for the men's singles. A length ahead of Rarezandra Nichita for Cyprus. So those two go through to the AB semi-final. A good push from Mekrobey Mamatkulov for Uzbekistan, but he closes into the line there for third place ahead of for Tunisia. Hani Spetia, he'll take fourth. And then coming into the last 150 or so meters, we have Nelson Mossetti for Kenya. So a huge round of applause, folks, for Nelson Mossetti for Kenya coming into the last 150 meters here of this second heat for the men's single.
男子シングルスカル予選2組目、1着でゴールしているのは5レーンのイタリア、前回5位の選手です。そして2着がキプロス。この2カ国が予選10決勝、準決勝 AB に進みます。3着にゴールしたのがウズベキスタン、4着がチュニジア、そして5着、残り 50m というところでしょうか、ケニアの選手が最後ゴールに向けて漕いでいます。皆さん大きな声援をお願いします。
Nelson Mossetti for Kenya crosses the line to complete the second heat for the men's single sculls. The third heat's already well underway, where we got Martin Tamaeta for Kiribati in lane one, Nicholas Aronov for USA in lane two, Jos Schwartz for the Netherlands in three, Masaki Suzuki for Japan in four, and Siripong Chawich Chonkul for Thailand in lane five.
男子シングルスカル予選3組目、浜野区 1000m を通過です。1レーンキリバス、2レーンアメリカ、3レーンオランダ、4レーン日本鈴木雅紀、5レーンタイ。
1000 meters in, Jos Schwartz for the Netherlands out in front, but Camilla, hot competition coming in from Siripong Chawich at Chonkul.
Indeed, hot competition, only a length separating these two scullers out at the front of the field. And also, don't write off the sculler from the US currently sitting in third, Nicholas Aronow, also there up contesting for these top two positions as he pulls alongside Chawich Chonkul of Thailand for second place.
男子シングルスカル予選、日本期待のシングルスカル鈴木雅紀選手、第2位の準決勝進出ポジションになんとか入りたいところです。現在第4位、第3位までに水を分けられているところですが、ここから後半挽回したいところです。第1位はオランダシュワルツ選手、一定身遅れてタイのチャイウィチチョンクル選手、アメリカのアロナウ選手がそれをフォローしています。第2位までに入るとこれが準決勝進出となります。
Charichonkul of Thailand just starting to tire now as the US sculler Nicholas Arenal now starts to row through. He's up there at 33 strokes a minute, the Thai sculler at 32, but it is still Schwartz of the Netherlands out in front by a length. It's just the USA and Thailand exchanging places as Thailand drop back into third. These three scullers with an ocean of clear water back to the next sculler from Japan. I'm sure there'll be lots of home support here for Suzuki of Japan. He's been sculling for 6 years now and he's currently sitting fourth in this field of the junior men's single sculls.
第4位を走るのは日本の鈴木正樹選手、浜松大平台高校3年生、170センチとボート選手としては小柄ながら78キロ、体重、力強いストロークを見せています。筋肉質な体を使って、この後半大きく挽回したいところです。第1位はやはりオランダのシュワルツ選手がまだリードを保っていますが、アメリカ、第2位のアメリカがやや迫ってまいりました。2艇が準決勝に進出します。
Well, this could be a beautifully executed move here by Nicholas Arenal of the USA as he moves up alongside the Dutch sculler Schwartz in lane three. The two now level as they go through 250 meters to go. And the US only at rate 30. This is really impressive stuff here in comparison to the Dutch 34. He's powering his way through and only, you know, four pips lower here than Schwartz of the Netherlands. This could be a really interesting fight to the line, Pete.
Yeah, it's a great sprint emerging here. Nicholas Arenal moving up the field so convincingly and now nearly drawing level, but Schwartz is putting on a great response here. He's gone to 36 into this last 100.
ずっとリードを広げてきたオランダですが、最後アメリカがすごい追い上げを見せています。1着まだオランダ、そして2着アメリカです。このままゴールでしょうか。
Well, Jost Schwartz, he led all the way down and he wasn't going to be pipped to the post, so he responds convincingly going to 36 and holding just under a length ahead of Arenal across the line. So Nicholas Arenal takes second place. They both progress through to the AB semi-final. Third place isChaiwichichonkul for Thailand ahead of the Japanese sculler Maisaki Suzuki coming in for fourth place. They've all eased right off now. Suzuki down at 25 strokes a minute. And then we've got Martin Tamaeta for Kiribati down at 31. So these athletes know that they'll be going through the repechage where we'll see them again next.
男子シングルスカル予選3組目、1着でゴールしたのはオランダ、そして2着がアメリカの選手。最後素晴らしい追い上げを見せました。この2カ国が予選 準決勝 AB に進みます。3着がタイ、4着に日本、5着にキリバスの選手が。
The men's single sculls, Piotr Plominski for Poland in lane one, Emil Nakov for Bulgaria in two, Ivan Brinza for Belarus in lane three, Seth O'Connor for Great Britain in four, and completing the field, Paul Leerkamp for Germany in lane five.
男子シングルスカル最終組4組はすでにスタート、1000メートルまで行っています。1レーンポーランド、2レーンブルガリア、3レーンベラルーシ、4レーンイギリス、5レーンドイツ。
1100 meters in already, and well, Robert, no surprise to see a real force for junior Belarusian rowing. Ivan Brinza leading the way.
Yes, Pete, he's certainly got experience on his side. He was the silver medalist at the European Junior Championships earlier in this season, held in Essen, Germany. A silver medal at the Youth Olympics last year in Argentina. Leading the way by clear water ahead of Emil Nakov of Bulgaria. Third place, well, that goes to the sculler on the near side, Paul Leerkamp of Germany. Followed by Piotr Plominski of Poland and Seth O'Connor of Great Britain.
シングルスカル予選第4組、3レーンを走っている、ベラルーシの選手が、非常に大きな体を、有効に使って、船を進めています。シングルスカルは非常に個人の、能力が、勝敗を大きく左右する、種目の一つとして考えられています。ただ、非常にテクニック的にも難しいので、このような強風の横風の中では、船の転覆、何が起こるか分かりませんので、目が離せない、 レースとなっています。
The leading contenders feel more spread out as we approach the 1500 meter signal. The only sculler who can come anywhere near Brinza is the Bulgarian Nakov, the man who took fourth position behind Brinza in Essen a couple of months ago. But there must be three lengths between these two scullers with 500 to go. Little bit of a change back along because Paul Lehrkamp for Germany coming under pressure from Plominski for Poland. Seth O'Connor for Great Britain having had a good third quarter. He's closed the gap, trying to be determined not to let the race slip away from him, but off the race pace that is being set by Brinza here. Fantastic performance by the Belarusian.
最後ラストスポーツクォーターに入ってきました。ベラルーシが依然として水を開けてリリードを奪っています。ブルガリアが迫っていますけれども、この差を縮めて抜き返すのは非常に困難だと思います。3位争いはドイツ、ポーランド、ほぼ横一線に並んでいます。
Brinza able to ease the rate down inside the last 250. He did all the work that was necessary in the first half of the course to establish that lead. Nakov for Bulgaria sitting there in clear water in second position, Pete.
Yeah, we so often see Ivan Brinza at the front of the field. He's no stranger to the podium, as we'd heard from Robert. We often see the Belarusians competing the Baltic Games as well for the Baltic Cup, and he's no stranger to winning that outright. So he's leading the way home here convincingly, just ticking it over at 30 strokes a minute. And current second place, Emil Nakov for Bulgaria, looking good, winding it up to 36.
前回大会4位のベラルーシの選手が1着でゴールを見せようと思って持っているところです。2着行くのがブルガリア。いいラストスパートを判定審査まで詰めています。
Last few strokes, Ivan Brinza takes the win for Belarus, and the fast sprinting Emil Nakov for Bulgaria takes second place. So they both go through to the AB semi. Third place, despite a great sprint to the line, Piotr Plominski for Poland will lead the way into the repechage, along with fourth place Paul Lehrkamp and fifth place Seth O'Connor.
男子シングルスカル第4組。1着でゴールしたのはベラルーシ、2着がブルガリア、この2カ国が準決勝 AB に進みます。3着ポーランド、4着ドイツ、5着イギリスが敗者復活戦に挑みます。
Just four races remain now here on day one of the 2019 World Rowing Junior Championships. We're into the four heats now for the women's single sculls. The first one already well underway. Rowiran Sakau for Thailand in lane one. Alina Berset for Switzerland in lane two. Sofia Aguirre-Vital for Mexico in three. Lauren Bass for Zimbabwe in four. And Sara Zamali for Tunisia in lane five.
女子シングルスカル予選。こちらは4組あります。現在1組が間もなく 1000m というところです。1レーンタイ、2レーンスイス、3レーンメキシコ、4レーンジンバブエ、5レーンチュニジア。
Fast approaching the 1000 meters. Robert, it's Camilla. It's good to see the Mexican athlete here leading the way.
Indeed, she's got a very powerful style here, Sofia Aguirre-Vital. She's out in front by about three quarters of a length, just with overlap. Here we've got Alina Berset in lane number two. She's clinging on to second with two to go through to the AB semi-final here in this first heat of the junior women's single sculls. These two sculls have opened up a couple of lengths of clear water back to Lauren Bass of Zimbabwe in third, and it's then close at the back of the field between Tunisia and Thailand.
女子シングルスカル予選2艇が準決勝に進みます。1位を行くのはメキシコ、ソフィア・アギーレ選手。広島、福山、芦田川でのキャンプを経てこのレースに挑戦しています。暑さに慣れたという部分もあるんでしょうか。非常に調子よくストロークを刻んでおります。第2位を行くのはスイス、アリーナ・バーセット選手。この2艇が今現在準決勝進出ポジションにおります。
still Mexico leading the way in this first heat of the junior women's single sculler, and I'm so impressed by the powerful finish that this single sculler has got. She absolutely levers the boat as they go past 750 metres to go, and that's keeping her ahead of the set of Switzerland, and she's managed to actually open up a little bit more of a gap. There's now clear water between the stern of the Mexican boat and the bow ball of the Swiss boat in these top two positions, but nobody challenging for these AB semi-final slots at the moment. Back in third, it's still Bass of Zimbabwe, but she's got clear water all around her in that third place position.
1位はメキシコ、ソフィア・アギーレ選手。さらに水をあけようというところ、大変力強いストロークです。ボディスイングの強さから、頭のポニーテールが揺れるぐらいの非常に力強いボディスイングでボートを加速しています。第2位スイス、やや遅れて第3位、第4位、第5位と、やや水が空いて、この3クルーは準決勝進出ポジションに行くのは非常に厳しいところか。メキシコ代表のソフィア・アギーレ選手、広島での合宿の成果を遺憾なく発揮しています。この世界ジュニア選手権は、大会運営側だけではなく、各協会にとってもリハーサルの大会です。ですから来年のオリンピックのためのリハーサルとして、合宿からレースまでの流れを、作っている。このリハーサルの中で、メキシコは非常にいい調子で、予選を戦っております。
We're closing in on 250 metres to go now, and it's a race for pride of place at the front of this field. It is still the Mexican sculler, Aguirre Vital, at the front, but the Swiss sculler charging once again, Alina Bassett. Now with overlap once again, she's throwing everything at it. She's raised the rating by a couple of pips. She's now up at 32 strokes a minute in comparison to the Mexican's 33. And she's powering now as she moves with every single stroke. She's gaining a few meters. This is incredible stuff. She's really winding it now into the finish. She's now up at 34. She's put the rating up two more pips. This is an incredible takeover here. What a move there from Alina Bassett as we move into the final 200 meters of this junior women's single sculler.
Amazing stuff. This young Swiss athlete now leading the way. She's motored straight past Aguirre Vital for Mexico. It's two to go through, so no real response from the young Mexican. I think she knows she's in a position to qualify for progression into the semi-finals, and there is such a comfortable margin of clear water back to third place, Lauren Bass for Zimbabwe, who's looking good for third at the moment. But it's an amazing sprint finish from Alina Bassett for Switzerland. All of these athletes will be taking note of that for the later rounds.
リードを保つのは3レーンのメキシコ、少し水をあけて2着行くのがスイス、そして3着ジンバブエ、4着タイ、5着チュニジアが追いかけます。
Alina Bassett for Switzerland is going to take the win in this first heat for the women's single sculls, setting us up well with a high benchmark for the three remaining heats. So she crosses the line a length and a half ahead of Sofia Aguirre Vital for Mexico. They both go through to the AB semi-final. Lauren Bass for Zimbabwe finishing up in third ahead of, well, it could still change. Rawiwan Sakau for Thailand currently holding on to fourth place. There's a length in it, and it's going to remain as it is. As Sakau for Thailand crosses the line ahead of Sara Zamali for Tunisia in fifth. We'll see them progress to the repechage.
1着でゴールしたのはスイスでした。2着がメキシコですね。この2着が準決勝 AB に進みます。そして3着がジンバブエ、4着タイ、5着がチュニジアでした。
On to the second heat then for the women's singles. Nihed Benchadli for Algeria in lane one. Miho Ueno for Japan in two. Anastasia Lubich for Russia in lane three. Daria Stavinoga for Ukraine in four. And then completing the field, Victoria Kalinowska for Poland in lane five.
女子シングルスカル予選2組目。1レーンアルジェリア、2レーン日本、上野美穂。3レーンロシア、4レーンウクライナ、5レーンポーランド。
1200 meters in, let's jump straight to Robert to find out how they're getting on.
Well, the story of this race so far is that it was led through the first 500 by Nihed Ben Chadli, the Algerian on the far side. But then inside the second quarter, Anastasia Lubich, the newcomer from Russia, took the lead. And it's the Russian who now leads by some 2.5 lengths ahead of Algeria, with Poland third and Ukraine fourth.
女子シングルスカル予選第2組、女子シングルスカルは、オリンピック種目の中で最も遅い種目になります。つまり最も長く漕がなきゃいけないという非常に過酷な種目でもあります。この種目に、日本チームのトリを務めます、上野さん、成立学園高校2年生が、果敢に挑んでおります。ストイックなトレーニングを積んで過酷なレースに臨む、高校2年生の女子、非常に強いメンタルがなければ、この場にはいられないと思います。環境が人間を強くするという言葉がありますが、この環境をこぎってなんとか、もっと強い、選手になってほしいと思います。
Well, this second heat of the junior women's single sculls is far from over. OK, Lubich leading the way home for Russia, but the Algerian seems to have front-loaded this race, and she is coming under increasing pressure from Victoria Kalinowska, the newcomer from Poland on the grandstand side, who maintains a narrow lead over Daria Stavinoga for Ukraine. Now, here's a big surprise, because it was the Ukrainian athlete who took the gold medal at the European Juniors in Essen earlier this year, and here she is languishing out of a qualifying position at the moment. But even as I'm describing the scene, both Kalinowska and Stavinoga have powered through and are trying to overhaul Ben Chadli for second.
ロシアの選手が圧倒的なリードを奪っています。長い手足、しかも上体も大きく使って非常に大きなストロークで差を広げています。2位争いが非常に熾烈になってきました。アルゼンチンが、リードしていましたが、手前5レーンの、ポーランドの選手が、抑えて、抜き去ったような感じです。
Yep, well, Kalinowska for Poland has now overhauled Ben Chadli, so she's taking on the second qualifying position. Stavinoga has finally woken up to the fact she's got a race on her hands here. Little glance to left and right for the Ukrainian athlete, and she has also overhauled the Algerian inside the last 200 meters. But what a great race this has turned out to be for the second qualifying position. Lubich leads the way home for Russia, with Kalinowska for Poland second.
And it could still all change in this last 200 meters. Kalinowska holding it 31 strokes a minute, but Stavinoga really moving now. 36 strokes a minute, winding it up for this fast sprint finish. It could still change. She could still qualify for the AB semi.
大きく水をあけてリードするのはロシア。そして2着争いが熾烈となっています。アルジェリア、ウクライナ、ポーランド、2着までが準決勝進出です。
Last couple of strokes, Anastasia Lubich for Russia takes the win in this second heat for the women's single sculls. And we can see now that Victoria Kalinowska for Poland has done just enough to hold on to second place there with a great performance. She crosses the line for second ahead of Stavinoga for Ukraine in third, and fourth place Ben Chadli for Algeria. That means that Lubich for Russia and Kalinowska for Poland progress to the AB semi. Stavinoga of Ukraine and Ben Chadli of Algeria progress through to the repechage along with Miho Ueno for Japan.
女子シングルスカル予選2組目は1着でゴールしたのはロシア、2着がポーランド。この2艇が準決勝 AB に進みます。3着ウクライナ、4着アルジェリア、5着に日本でした。
Third heat now for the women's single sculls, the penultimate race of our day here on day one of the 2019 World Rowing Junior Championships. Lane one for the People's Republic of China, we have Zhu Jiyi. We then have Bettina Ziska for Hungary in lane two, Isabel van Opzeeland for the Netherlands in lane three, Chai Qingyi for Hong Kong, China in four, and Malika Tagmatova for Uzbekistan in lane five.
2019世界ボートジュニア選手権大会、大会初日、残すところあと2レースとなりました。女子シングルスカル予選3組目、1レーン中国、2レーンハンガリー、3レーンオランダ、4レーン香港、5レーンウズベキスタンです。
Well, they're just going through 1,200 meters. And for the last time today, I'm going to leave you in the capable hands of Camilla. Now, Camilla, no surprise to see Van Opzeeland leading the way here.
Yeah, she's such a tall athlete, Van Opzeeland, and she's out there sculling her best race at 33 strokes a minute with 750 metres to go. She can't be touched at this point in time, but behind her, a great race developing now between the Hungarian sculler Siska and Sue of China in lane number one. Actually, the Hungarian now has just rode through the Chinese sculler as we speak, and she's now up to a length into second. And remember, that second position, all very important because it progresses you through to the AB semi-final.
女子シングルスカル予選、ここでの注目は何といってもオランダ、第3レーンのオランダ、オプツィーランド選手、3回目の世界ジュニア挑戦になります。16歳の時にこのシングルスカルで7位となり、昨年はフォアでの出場でした。今年は満を持して、一番過酷だと言われるこの女子シングルスカルの種目での優勝候補の一角になります。第2位を行きますのはハンガリーシスカ選手、第3位に中国クイ選手、アジアの優中国クイ選手、1000メーター付近までは準決勝進出ポジションの2位におりましたが、ハンガリーのシスカ選手が今は準決勝進出ポジションに名乗りを上げています。第4位、第5位にいる香港、ウズベキスタンはやや遅れを取っております。
A hugely impressive performance here by Van Opzeeland of the Netherlands. A year out of the single scull last year to race the women's four, but she won the B final in this boat class back in 2017, and she's come back now after a break from the single last year and displaying her dominance in this third heat of the junior women's single scull. And that was a great move by Siska of Hungary with 750 meters to go, and she really has solidified her place now in second position.
ハンガリー第2位のハンガリーのシスカ選手のスパートが非常に鋭い切れ味を見せています。第1位オプシーランド選手はそれでもセーフティーリードを保っている状態、アジア勢の3クルーはやや苦しい状態です。
So a hugely spread hit field here between all five of our single scullers in this heat of the junior women's single scull, but no one to touch the Dutch sculler Pete.
Yeah, she's such a powerful athlete, leading the way here at 32 strokes a minute ahead of Siska for Hungary, also at 32. Everybody else seems to have eased off. The remaining three scullers now at 29 or 28 strokes a minute, I think, resigned to the fact that they'll be going through that additional race, or I like to look at it as the additional opportunity to get through to the latter rounds of competition, the repechage. But out in front, Isabel van Opzeeland.
先頭行くのはオランダ、2点差をつけています。2着ハンガリー、3着に中国の選手が追い上げています。まもなくゴールラインです。
Van Opzeeland for the Netherlands takes the win here in the third heat for the women's single sculls, 2.5 lengths of clear water ahead of Siska for Hungary, and then coming in for third place on the far side, Xu Jiyi for the People's Republic of China.And the field rather spread out now, as we can see on the near side. Malika Tagmatova for Uzbekistan coming in for fourth ahead of Chai Qingyi for Hong Kong, China in fifth.
女子シングルスカル予選3組目。1着でゴールしたのはオランダ。2位以下を大きく引き離してのゴールとなりました。2着がハンガリー、3着に中国。そして4着、間もなくゴールのウズベキスタン。ゴールです。5着に香港が間もなくゴールラインを迎えます。
On now to the last race of our day, the fourth and last heat for the women's single sculls. Alexandra Förster for Germany in lane one, Violeta Levinocka for Latvia in lane two, Caitlin Gildersleeve for the USA in lane three, Barbara Podrazilova forThe Czech Republic in lane 4 and Abigail Dent for Canada in lane 5.
本日最後のレースとなりました。女子シングルスカル予選4組。1レーンドイツ、2レーンラトビア、3レーンアメリカ、4レーンチェコ、5レーンカナダです。
Well, this race just passing through 1200 meters and I'm going to leave you in the capable hands for the last time today of Robert Trahan Jones.
Thanks, Pete. Well, this fourth heat of the junior women's singles is all about Germany and the USA. Alexandra Förster, the bronze medalist from Essen, took the 500-meter split. Then she was overhauled approaching the halfway mark by the newcomer from the USA, Caitlin Gildersleeve. And that's the one and two. They have clear water, four lengths of clear water after 12:50.
本日の最終レースとなります女子シングルスカル予選4組、3レーンのアメリカが非常に、高いレートで、首位を、守っています。1レーンのドイツは、ゆったりとしたペースで、そんなに差を開けられることなくしっかりとついていっているので、今後ラストスパートで、追い抜く可能性があると思います。水を開けて、3位には、5レーンのカナダ、ちょっとこの、差ではなかなか2位に入って準決勝に進むのはちょっと困難じゃないかというふうに思います。
High drama. While Ken has been bringing you the news in the local language, because we have a capsize, Violeta Levinuka, the Latvian who was trailing the field in fifth position, has slipped her boat. But the safety crews are on site, I'm pleased to say. But at the head of the field, 500 to go, as Caitlin Gildersleeve works hard to retain that lead. I've got her at 36 strokes a minute. She's been at 37 through the third quarter against Förster, who's just tapping her boat along and maintaining the boat speed down at 29. The best of the rest, Barbara Podrazilova for the Czech Republic, with Abigail Dent of Canada back in fourth.
最後のラストスパートに入りました。アメリカがさらにレートを上げて40近くでコーディアルに見ます。ドイツはもう2位を確保したということで、ラストスパートはあんまりしていないので、ゆったりとコーディアルままです。
Approaching the closing stages of this final race of the morning's racing here on the Sea Forest Waterway. And Caitlin Gildersleeve, the newcomer from the Oklahoma City High Performance Center in the USA, entering the red boy zone, the last 250 meters, still pumping it in at 36 strokes a minute. She has worked so, so hard, but she deserves a win here and a place in the semi-final, where, barring a disaster, she's going to be joined by Alexander Förster of Germany.
And a great race from Förster. She's at 29 strokes a minute, so underrating the American by 7 strokes a minute and holding a length down. So with a bit of a burst, she may well steal that lead as they enter these red boys here, which is often the signal for these athletes to really go for it and give every last drop of energy into the closing stages. But it's two to go through, so we may see them conserve energy rather than sprint it out.
ずっと先頭を保ってきたアメリカの選手はここでストロークを落としたような感じ。2着までが準決勝進出ということで、アメリカ、ドイツ、こちらが1着2着でゴールしようとしているところです。そして続くのがカナダ、チェコ、ラトビアの順番に前を追いかけます。
So Caitlin Gildersleeve for the USA takes the win here in the last heat of the women's single sculls, the last race of our day here at the 2019 World Rowing Junior Championships. And she's joined by Alexandra Förster for Germany to progress through to that AB semi-final. Coming in for third place then, Abigail Dent for Canada leads the way into the repechage, and she'll be joined by Barbara Podrazilova for the Czech Republic. And then coming in for sixth place, just into this last 700 meters, we have Violeta Levinoka for Latvia. So we'll see her race again nonetheless in that repechage.
女子シングルスカル予選4組目、1着でゴールしたのはアメリカ、2着がドイツ、この2カ国が準決勝 AB に進みます。3着以下大きく引き離して、最後は余裕を持てのゴールだったので、明日以降の準決勝が楽しみです。3着でゴールしたのはカナダ、4着チェコ、5着現在ゴールまで750メートルぐらいのところにいるでしょうか。ラトビアの選手のゴールを待っています。
What are you waiting for? Don't you wanna learn to deal with fear? the right excuse? Are you waiting for a sign to choose? While you're waiting, it's the time you lose. What are you waiting for? Don't you wanna spread your wings and fly? Don't you really wanna live your life? Don't you wanna love before you die? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for?
Well, folks, what a great day we've had here on day one of the 2019 World Rowing Junior Championships, Tokyo. 2 hours worth of heats. We've been through nearly all of the small boat heats in the last two and a bit hours, and there's still plenty to look forward to tomorrow morning when we get through the remaining heats for the larger boat classes, and of course the women's pair sat right in amongst them. So racing tomorrow starts at 9:30, same as it did today, so do come back and join us early tomorrow morning where we'll run through those remaining heats up until 10:30, and then of course we're on to the repechages for the boat classes that we've seen today. So repechages running from 10:40 until the last race of tomorrow, the last repechage for the women's single scull at 11:55. So we've got 2.5 hours worth of racing to look forward to tomorrow. Same conditions very much as we've experienced today, with a slight tail crosswind and very, very warm sunny conditions we can hope for tomorrow as well. I've thoroughly enjoyed today's racing. I hope you have too from here in the grandstands. Just to repeat, we'd still love to hear from you on all your social media channels. Hit us on Twitter, Instagram, and use that hashtag WRJChamps, because we'd love to hear from you between now and tomorrow, of course, as well as you think about the racing that's happened through this morning and on to tomorrow. A huge thank you as well to all of the volunteers and officials that have helped to set us off to a great start here for this week's worth of racing at the World Rowing Junior Championships. I know it will continue to be a great week, but for the time being, that's going to wrap us up for today. So thank you for joining us. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
2019世界ボートジュニア選手権大会、大会初日が終わりました。8月7日水曜日、大会初日が今現在幕を下ろしました。本日予選が7種目行われましたが、明日も同じ時間9時半から始まります。9時半から男女ダッシュ付きフォア、女子ペア、男女ダッシュなしフォア、男子エイトなどが行われます。10時40分からは敗者復活戦が7種目、そして最後の種目が11時55分からスタートとなっています。明日も同じように天気とても暑くなることが予想されております。皆さん熱中症対策には十分気をつけてください。
So just before we say our final goodbyes, the organizing committee of the 2019 World Rowing Junior Championships would like to thank their partners.
2019世界ボートジュニア選手権大会海の森水上競技場にご来場いただいた皆様、本当にありがとうございました。アスリートの皆さん、そしてボランティアの皆さん、本当にありがとうございました。また本大会は8社1団体のご協力ご協賛により開催されております。オフィシャルパートナー、アース製薬株式会社、株式会社セレスポ、株式会社野村工芸社、久光製薬株式会社、丸大食品株式会社、電源開発株式会社、積水化学工業株式会社、双日株式会社、特別協賛東京都、以上8社1団体のご協力ご協賛により開催されておりました。